I'd like to thank Dr. Bari for inviting me on this instruction course, AI in diabetic retinopathy. So like all new technology, there is this Gartner's hype cycle where we trigger a lot of expectation, then we get disillusioned and finally get a plateau of productivity. Like the dot-com burst, we had so many software companies, they burst, and then the one which were practical, which had technology, survived. Similarly, in AI, we're going to have this hype about a lot of diagnosis, and then we'll find that we don't have enough doctors to treat what we have diagnosed, and then there will be a practical stoppage. So the aim of any screening program is to diagnose DME and PDR, which are two leading causes of avoidable blindness. But the cost of screening should actually be less than the cost of a doctor's consultation. And there should be large volumes to screen. It cannot be for 10 patients that an endocrinologist puts up a camera and it's not going to be practical after some time. The limitation is that the technology is missing some lesions, like the raised lesions, the cost of the fundus camera, the manpower to treat the diabetes. The low cost of treatment is not possible. It's very costly with the anti-VEGF. And the AI, who will validate the findings? Who will bear the medical legal consequences of the AI technology? So at the moment, the only screening program which is there worldwide, I think, health system is in England, not even in US that they screen as a national population registry, they screen every diabetic. But we will have to, once we have databases, we will start screening all the diabetics. We need to reallocate the skilled manpower to take the photographs and overcome the barriers of distance and healthcare access. So it helps us predict which patient will have vision-threatening diabetic retinopathy so we can prevent blindness or handicap. I'm not expert on AI, but initially we had this machine-based learning where we extracted each feature, every soft rate, and we copied it. While deep learning will learn on the go and help you diagnose diabetic retinopathy better. So initially you train the set, so the one up to about 1 lakh photographs are given to a software to analyze and then create this database. But it will have to be region-based because the pigmentation level will be different in all different population. And finally, we need to validate it. These are photographs courtesy Dr. Manisha Agarwal, who is using an AI platform in our hospital. You see the both eye, you can see the large cups. You can see occasional microaneurysm here, but you can see the ring of hard exudate and you see the microaneurysm. So what does it show? It shows that the dot and blot hemorrhages are present in the left eye and the hard exudate and glaucoma and one. It does not pick up the microaneurysms in the right eye, which are not important. So at the moment, we have four technologies which are being used across the world. The IDX DR system, which is FDA approved in US, it is based on the single camera linked to the internet, and it picks up those patients which needs to be referred to the ophthalmologist. The other is the Red Marker DR, UK-based AI screening program. Third is iArt. Fourth is the Google Incorporated. The data was given by Shankar Netral and Arvind Eye System. And we are waiting for it to be available publicly for us to use. The drawbacks of any technology is that you will need to grade it. The Google system required about 60 ophthalmologists to grade it. And the low quality images will be a problem because majority of the elderly population would have a cataract, that the quality of vision will go down. We will need trained staff to take photographs, the fundus cameras. As the cost of cameras come down and we can have good chips inside a mobile phone and we can have links to a mobile phone with a huge quality, because at the moment you have cameras from 2 megapixel to 20 megapixel, the quality is there. So does it classify? Some software classify into mild, moderate, severe with CME. At the moment, if I have a diabetic patient, I will take a color photograph. If doubt, I will do an OCT. I will do a FA or an OCTA to pick up a small NV. So what trial I did in my practice is that all my diabetic patients, all my patients for last 2 years, I'm taking a fundus photograph with a red free. And I found the moment I shifted to a fundus camera, I was able to diagnose much better. I was able to pick up more lesions. So just the availability of a camera helped me become a better ophthalmologist. So we need every ophthalmologist with a fundus camera. Instead, we are providing every endocrinologist with a small camera who can diagnose the disease. So at the moment, all the software are based in fundus photographs. at the moment, we also do not depend solely on a fundus photograph. Sometimes you may have a patient with a vision of 6-12 and you may have a small CME in the macula, which is picked up on the OCT. So we will have to have software which integrate the DR with the OCT to have a more sensitivity of picking up the diabetic retinopathy. This is the first software, the IDX DR camera, which has an online software which picks a diagnosis. So we will require software linked into the machine. So even if it's offline, it should be able to pick up. So they use 900 patients. I will not go into details. It is available on the net. For those who want to go into details, can look up the details on the net. The development of AI will be the ownership and the revenue sharing. Who owns the software? After all, every photograph helps the software to learn better. You are giving data to the software company. So is it your data? Is it the patient's data? Or is it software data? And now that we all know that I can identify a person by the retinal pattern, so can you anonymize the data of every patient? And they will be malpractice liability. Who will be liable for it? The patient privacy. So we require consent forms. But the main thing is that the more the cameras come in, there's going to be more diagnosis of diabetic retinopathy, more work for the ophthalmologist. So the ophthalmologist gains whether he screens, he or she screens, or the machine screens. You want to have more patients. You have almost 6 crore diabetics. I don't think even 1 crore of them or even 60 lakhs are screened annually. Now, softwares are being made with OCT linkage to pick up early. So maybe the optometrist can do the OCT and fundus photograph and then know which one to refer. So these are various publications which you can all go through if you wish to go into more detail. But in short, I'll say the application of AI finally may be linked to your phone, screening at home or in non-medical. Maybe you have fundus cameras in malls or you may have it at the optometrist shop. Referral from primary care. So I think the patient wants to not go to multiple centers. So the primary medical or the endocrinologist is going to have the cameras. It will help assist physician to make diagnosis. It frees the physician from repetitive large volume work and alert the physician to the problem so they can at least make the patient more alert. The screening facilities versus treatment. If you're going to increase the screening, you will have to increase the treatment facilities. And at present, the cost of anti-VEGF is quite high. The fundus camera cost is high. We will require cheaper cameras. At the moment, we are making software, whether for the ophthalmologist, primary care, or for the optometrist to do that. Hazy media is going to be a problem. The pickup rate of elevated to the fibrous element, traction detachment, is not there at the moment, so sensitive in the softwares. The medical legal responsibility is going to be there, and anonymizing the data is going to be a problem. So we will end up needing more ophthalmologists. Instead of making the work less, there's always going to be more work with technology. And the software will have to be made offline. Thank you so much.